Welcome back. I'm Reed Gray, your neighborhood expert, and today we're unpacking the best areas to live in near Greenville, South Carolina. When I say near, I'm going to tell you about some surrounding towns that are still considered greater Greenville area. They all cater to different needs, and once we've had a chance to talk, I'll be able to direct you towards which options may be the best fit for you. I'm talking Greer, Simpsonville, Travelers Rest, Malden, and Fountain Inn. Heck, there's also some great opportunities in Spartanburg as well. Take the quiz in the description below to see what area it recommends for you and let me know. We'll see how it did. So the Greenville, South Carolina area offers several excellent options and places to live, each with its own unique characteristics and advantages. When buying a home, reach out to my friend Harrison Williamson with Cross Country Mortgage for all of your mortgage needs. I like to refer to him as the man with the money to help make this all possible. But without further ado, here are some of the best areas near Greenville. So number one, downtown Greenville, and I feel like this is cheating because if we're thinking about moving to Greenville, we can't get any more near Greenville than the downtown areas. But oftentimes, our main street is a central point of focus for prospective home buyers, so I feel that it's probably a good idea to start here. If you prefer city living with easy access to dining, entertainment, amenities, downtown Greenville offers a vibrant urban lifestyle. Here you're going to find a mix of historic and modern architecture, parks, restaurants, shops, all within walking distance. For these areas, I encourage you to specifically check out North Main, Augusta Road, Alta Vista, Chanticleer, Dunedin, Overbrook, Parkins Mill, and Pleasant Valley. All of these are going to be kind of various price points and may cater to your needs. Number two, Greer. Located just northeast of Greenville, Greer offers a suburban setting with a strong sense of community. Greer has recently made all the lists as far as growing places, great place to live, up and coming. So why is that? Well, Greer has a charming downtown area, good schools, and convenient access to major highways and the GSP airport, making it popular among families and commuters. Not only is Greer convenient to Greenville, but also to Spartanburg, and parts of it also offer rural settings. So you've got the suburban lifestyle, and you've also got the rural lifestyle and various price points in between to cater to your specific needs. Number three, Simpsonville. So situated south of Greenville, Simpsonville is known for its family-friendly neighborhoods, excellent schools, recreational opportunities, and it has a mix of newer developments and established communities, all with easy access to shopping centers and outdoor activities. Simpsonville is a great place to live. Check it out. If you have any specific questions, let me know. I'd be happy to talk about it. Number four, we're looking at Malden, which is adjacent to Simpsonville. Malden offers a mix of residential and commercial developments. It also has a diverse population, good schools, and parks, making it a desirable place to live for families and young professionals. So what I'm going to hit on there real quick is we're talking about parks in Malden. There we have Conestee Nature Preserve. Greenville Little League is also attached to that. There's some dog parks there. Really beautiful. I love it. I used to live in Malden, and that was something that I did on a weekly basis, was go over to that park. Now, young professionals, let's talk about that for a second. So in an earlier video that I did, I called Malden the townhome mecca of Greenville, and I still stand by that. And here's why. So a young professional, you may be a first-time buyer. And what that means to you is, hey, maybe my budget is here right now, but I still want to be close to the downtown Greenville area. Parts of Malden, you're going to be 12-15 minutes. Hey, that might be a great first property for you to look at. So that offers townhomes, and then it also offers established single family homes. Again, all with a close proximity to downtown. Number five is Travelers Rest, located north of Greenville. TR is kind of a picturesque town nestled in the foothills of the Blue Ridge Mountains. So TR is hot, and it offers a relaxed pace of life, outdoor recreation opportunities such as hiking and biking trails, and a quaint downtown area with shops and restaurants. I love TR. And it tends to be high on the list of inbound buyers because it caters to different needs and you're still relatively close to downtown Greenville there. Number six is Taylor's. So Taylor's is situated between Greer and Greenville, and it's a suburban community known for its affordability and convenience. It has a range of housing options, good schools, and easy access to amenities in both Greer and Greenville. If you want to know more about Taylor's, let me know. I'd love to talk to you about the old Taylor's Mill and kind of what they've done there as far as restaurants and, you know, entertainment and things like that. It's pretty cool. That's one thing that you'll see a lot here in Greenville is refurbished old mills. Greenville is an old mill town, and with that, they've converted some into apartments, into condos. This one just so happens to be kind of mixed use, commercial rather. Go to the brewery, go throw darts, go hang out. There's even a wedding venue there. Nonetheless, let's keep rolling. So number seven, we're going to look at Fountain Inn. So south of Simpsonville, Fountain Inn offers a mix of small town charm and modern conveniences. It has a historic downtown area, a little bit smaller downtown area than Greer. It's got parks and recreational facilities, as well as easy access to major highways for commuters. So Fountain Inn, it's more rural out there, growing area, probably a good place to invest as our Greenville area continues to grow and sprawl outwards. Fountain Inn also has a growing industrial industry, as Tesla has just announced a new plant that will be headed that direction soon. So these are just a few of the many great areas that Greenville, South Carolina has to offer, each of which with its own unique lifestyle and amenities. I would say that it's essential to consider the factors such as housing preferences, proximity to work or schools, and desired community amenities when choosing the best area for you to live in. One thing to keep in mind is that all of these areas also cater to different price points. If you're planning a trip to Greenville, I encourage you to check out my friend Mike Cruz's Make Greenville Yours tour. And Mike will make it a very worthwhile afternoon as he takes you around different areas, not only helping getting you acquainted with the upstate, but also buyers often leave with a good idea as to where they'd like to live, helping streamline our home search. If you're considering making a move to Greenville, I'd love to know. I'd love to connect with you, say hello, welcome you, and help you land in the right area and home for you. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.